Biography of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Dear students, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the second Khalifa of Muslim Ummah of Khulafa'i Rashidun, and the primary identity of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was born in 583 AD in the Banu Adiyan class of Quraysh tribe, and Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's father's name was Khattab and his mother's name was Hantama. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu received Islam at the age of 33 at 6th Hijri of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, why Hazrat Umar radiallahu write down the incident of receiving Islam. Dear students, all we know the more or less the incident of receiving Islam by Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was a great leader of Kafirs during Makki life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One day Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu decided to kill Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but on the way of going to the house of Prophet, a man asked told Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu that your sister and your brother-in-law also received Islam, so you should control there. Then Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala went to his sister's house and tortured them severely and seriously. But in his days, when they rejected that they will not give up Islam, they received Islam and they will not give up Islam, even if Umar killed also them. Then in his days, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala thought about the depthness of their belief, and by the grace of Almighty Allah the Most High, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's mind started to change, and he decided that he will go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he will receive Islam. And after receiving Islam, we know Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was titled as Farooq by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After receiving Islam, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Oh Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, aren't you the true prophet? Isn't Islam the only religion? Isn't the Kaaba the house of Muslim?" Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, "Yes." Then Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu declared that there is no secrecy from today. From today we will observe Salat in the ground of Kaaba. And thus this text of courage of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu inspired the Muslim Ummah, Muslim community, even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after being placed on Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, declared him as Farooq. Farooq means one who differentiates between truth and falsehood. As Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu disclosed Islam from secrecy, that's why Rasulullah declared him as Farooq of Islam, the differentiator between truth and falsehood. Now we will discuss about the upright judgment of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, some parts of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's character. For this special and unique characteristics, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is the great leader of the world. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is an example of the leaders of the world for all the ages. Now we are going to discuss some special parts of his characters. First one, justice and fairness. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu established justice in his area, in his state, and he always tried to maintain fairness. He never differentiated between rich and poor. He never differentiated between well and woe, even his near and dear. Always he used to treat each and everyone as the slave of Allah, as a human being only. That's why Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala established justice. And the next point, never discriminate. And he was an iron-handed ruler. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu never discriminate among anybody, and he strictly used to follow the rules of Islam, the rules of and regulations of state. And thus we know an incident of beating his own child Abu Shama. When Hazrat Umar heard that Abu Shama received wine, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu punished them by his own hand. It is the example of his justice, example of his indiscriminatory behavior, well and low, near and dear. And we know the responsibility of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after being Khalifa, he declared, if any dog also died in the bank of Furat River. And as Umar is the responsible, Umar is the ruler of this part or this land, Umar will be responsible for the death of that dog also. That means he is the he was the responsible person. Even we know Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu used to roam over his locality and area in the deep night. And one night when he was roaming, he heard the crying of a child from a tent. Then Hazrat Umar saw that the mother has no food and he was only boiling water. And after seeing it, after observing it, Hazrat Umar radiallahu carried flour, ghee or oil to the house of that woman and supported him and helped him. And this is the example of responsibility of a ruler of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And we know Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one day he was returning from his office. He heard the crying of a mother who was in giving birth of child. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala sent his own wife to that slum, to that mother, to help him during this crisis. It was the responsibility of a leader of the Muslim. And again, we know Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was a transparent leader. His accountability, his all types of responsibility was exemplary. And one day, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to arrange each Friday to hear the questions and problems of the people. And one day, when he was hearing the problems, one man asked Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after observing the long cloth or long shirt of Umar, he asked, O Khalifa, you are also a citizen as like as me, but your shirt is longer than me. Why is it? Then the elderly son of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abdullah ibn Umar, solved the problem. He said that your answer is true, it's correct, but and my father also had received same cloth like you and me, but as a part, as a citizen also, I have also received a part of cloth, and I have given my part of cloth to my father, and by adjusting with both the cloths, my father's cloth is my father's shirt is somehow long, as he is the imam of the mosque, that's why he need this long shirt. And thus Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu confirmed his transparency, confirmed his accountability, and it was the Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We know the kindness of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was a very kindful man. We know the visiting history of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu to Jerusalem. During the Jerusalem visit, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu helped his servant by giving him the seat. The seat of the Khalifa, and he didn't discriminate between a Khalifa and a slave. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu supported him, helped him, and treated him as like as a human being. Even both are equal as human being, as the slave of Allah. Thus Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu became the true ruler, became the perfect ruler of the Muslim world, and an example for the today's world, and for all over the world. And these are the incident of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. These are the speciality of character of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We will try to follow the character of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu.